In this example, we want to test a claim about the population mean mu at the given level of significance using the given sample statistics. We are given that the claim mu equals 40, alpha, the level of significance, is 0.05, sigma, the population standard deviation, is 3.46, and our sample statistics are x bar is equal to 38.7 and the sample size is 51. First, we want to identify the null and alternative hypothesis. We are told that the population mean is equal to 40. The equal sign must always go with the null. So that's going to be the null, and we're also told that's the claim. So the alternative is the opposite, which is not equal to 40. Because of the not equal sign, this is a two-tailed test. We want to calculate the standardized test statistic. We can use a z-test because we know the sample size is greater than 30, and we also have the population standard deviation. So we can use a z-test. We'll plug in x bar minus mu divided by sigma divided by the square root of n. When we do this, we get 38.7 minus 40 divided by 3.46 divided by the square root of 51. This ends up being negative 1.3 divided by 0.4845. When you do this division, you end up with negative 2.68. This is the test statistic. Next, we want to find the critical values. We look at the alpha level, the level of significance. We see that it's 0.05. Because it's a two-tailed test, we must divide the alpha level by 2. And here you can see that this ends up being 0.025. So to find the critical values, we're going to have two of them. One is going to be negative and one is going to be positive. To find that, what we need to do is simply find the area to the left of this critical value that has an area of 0.025. Now we can use the function on the TI called inverse norm, and when we use this feature, we would type in 0.025 for the area to the left of this z, comma 0, comma 1, and this will equal negative 1.96. Or you can use the table that has the area under the standard normal distribution. Now, by symmetry, we know that the positive critical value will be positive 1.96. So therefore, the two critical values are going to be plus and minus 1.96. Now, to determine the outcome and the conclusion of this test, we compare our test statistic with where it's located in comparison to the critical values and the rejection regions. Our test statistic, negative 2.68, falls within the rejection region on the normal bell curve, which means we need to reject the null hypothesis. So we can say that since the test statistic z is equal to negative 2.68 and it falls into the rejection region, then we will reject the null at the 5% significance level. Since the null was the claim, then we also reject the claim.